Hello students, we are back here to study squares and square roots. In the previous session, we solved question 3, square roots of 100 by repeated subtraction. Now, square root of 169 also we have to solve by the same method of repeated subtraction. Let us solve by that method, by repeated subtraction. Here you can see 169 is the value. We shall write first the odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23. Now, step by step, we shall do the subtraction. 169. The first odd value we are subtracting. So this is what? 168. 168 minus 3. We are getting 165. Third step. We are doing the calculation. Third step. 165 minus the third odd value minus 5 is equals to 160. Fourth step, 165 minus the fourth odd value 7. This becomes 158. 158. Fifth step, 158 minus 9, we get 149. Sixth step, 149 minus 149, it is the next step. What? 149 minus the next value 11. So it is 138. I hope you are understanding. We are just subtracting the values. Seventh step, 138 minus 13, that is the next odd value. It is 125. Eighth step, 125 minus 15, it is 110. Ninth step, 110 minus 17, this comes to 93. Tenth step, 93 minus 19, just a minute, I will just cross check here. I have a doubt here. For 110 minus 17, this becomes 0, this becomes 10, 3. Yeah, it is correct, no doubt. Just I was in a bit of confusion, so no worries. 93 minus 19, it comes to what? It comes to 93 minus 19, this becomes 8, this becomes 13. 9 and 13 minus 9 is 4. and 8 minus 1 is 7. So it is 74. After that, the next step, 11th step, 74 minus 21. So this comes to 4 minus 1, 3, 7 minus 2, 5. 12th step, 53 minus 23. How much we are getting? It is 53 minus 23, 3 minus 3, 0. I guess something has gone wrong somewhere. We have to cross check it. See, 169 minus 1 is 168, 168 minus 3 is 165, 165 minus 5 is 160. 165, oh, here the things have gone wrong. Here you can see I have done a mistake here. The things have gone wrong here. So it is 160 minus 7. And from here the things have gone wrong. We shall do it once again. Okay. Here the things have gone wrong. We shall do these steps once again because these corrections. Here it is. Here also it is 160 minus 7 is 153. 153 minus 9 is 144. The next odd number we have taken, 144 minus 13. Sorry, minus 11, not 13, minus 11 is 133. 133 minus 13 is 120. Why? 3 minus 3, 0, 3 minus 1, 2, the digit in hundreds place, as it is 1. 120 minus 15 is 105. 105 minus 17. 105 minus 17. How much it comes to? 88 it comes to. 88 minus 19. This comes to how much? 69 minus 21. Am I right? 88 minus 19. So this becomes 7. Yeah. This is 9. This is 69. Right it is. And above that, I should not make a mistake here. 105 minus 17. This 10 will become 9. And this will become 10. 8. Yeah, it is 88. Right. We are on the track. No need of worrying. So this comes to 9 minus 1, 8, 6 minus 2, 4. 48 minus 23, 8 minus 3 it comes to 5, and 4 minus 2 it comes to 2. And the 13th step. Now I have not mentioned here actually. I have to mention the next odd number so that what it happens, After 23, the next odd number is 25. So 25 minus 25 is equals to 0. How many steps totally? 13 steps it took for to make 169 0 by subtraction. Therefore, we can write here square root of 169 is equals to 13. This is by the subtraction, repetition subtraction method. Let us move to the next question. Now here, find the square root. What the next question is? The next question is, find the square roots of the following numbers by the prime factorization method. Now, there are totally 10 sums. I will not solve all the 10 sums. Do one thing, that I will solve from the sixth sum. You people solve the first five sums and I will solve from the sixth sum. Now what is the sixth sum here? 9604. The square root of 9604 by prime factorization method. Okay, let us see how to solve it. Here we are erasing this. 9604 by prime factor. Let us factorize it. Now this can be first divided by 2, because at the end digit is an even number. So by 2 we can. 2 fours are 8. 1 we are carrying next. 2 eights are 16. 1 is remaining. No, sorry, not here. 1 is remaining. Here it is nothing. 0 as it is. 2 twos are 4. Again by 2 we can divide. 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 0 as it is, 2 1s are. Now by 2 we cannot divide because the number is ending with the digit 1. So we cannot divide by 2. So let us check by 3. So the divisibility by 3, how we can understand whether a number is divisible by 3? We are going to sum the digits, and if the sum is a multiple of 3, then it is divisible by 3. So let us check. 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 2, 7. So 7 is not a multiple of 3. So we cannot. Then after 3, we are checking for 5. What is the divisibility test for 5, or what is the criteria for 5? If the number is ending with the digit 5 or 0, then only it is divisible by 5. This is neither ending with 5 nor with 0, it is ending with 1, so we cannot. After 5, let us check for 7. Let us try for 7. Okay, 7 threes are 21. How much remaining? 3 remaining, so it is becoming next 30. 7 4s are 28. Out of 30, if 28 is minus, 2 is remaining. So here it is becoming 21. 7 3s are 21. I guess you are understanding it. Next, again by 7 we shall try. 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35. So it is less than 35 and greater than 28. So 7 4s are 28. 7, just a minute, it has become 7 4s are 28. 28 means 6 remaining. The next number is becoming 63. 7 9s are 63, 7 7s are 49, 7 1s are 7. So the factors of 9604 are 2 into 2 into 7 into 7. The pair of 7 is 2 times and pair of 2 is once. These are what, these are the factors. We want to find the square root. So we are pairing them. One pair of 2, one pair of 7 and one more pair of 7. Therefore then square root of 9604 is equals to 2 into 7 into 7. How much it comes to? 49 2s are 9 2s are 18. 4 2s are 8 plus 1 9, means it is what? Square root of 9604 is 98, or in other words 98 square is equals to 9604. Okay, this is the cross verification that we have done. And what is the main thing? Square root of 9604 is 98. This is our answer. I guess you have understood it. Let us see the next sum. 5929. Let us find the factors of it. This number will not get divided by 2. Reason is very simple. It is not ending with an even digit. 9 is not an even digit. It is not an even number. It is odd. So the number is not ending by an even digit. Okay. So let us check for 3, the next prime number. 9 plus 2 11 11 plus 9 20 20 plus 5 25 25 is not coming in 3's table. It is not a multiple, so not divisible by 3. Let us check for 5. As mentioned in the previous sum, the number is not ending with 5 or 0, so not divisible by 5. Let us check for 7. Let us check for 7. 7 7s are 49, 7 8s are 56. 56 means remaining is 3. 32 means it is 7 4s are 28. 7 4s are 28. Because 7 5s are 35, but it is very small. So 7 4s are 28. 4 remaining, okay. 7 7s are 49. Let us proceed further. Again by 7. 7 1s are 7, remaining 1. The next value is becoming 14. 7 2s are 14. And 7 1s are 7. Okay. Now we know very well that 121 is 11 square. So 11 1s are and 1 is remaining. The next value will become 11. Again 11 1s are. Or the criteria for finding whether a particular value is divisible by 11, what we have to do? We have to add the digit in 1's place. The odd places digits we are adding. This is a 3 digit number. The first digit here and the third digit, if we add 1 plus 1, it becomes 2. And the even place digit, that is 2. 2 minus 2, it becomes 0. This is the criteria for checking a value whether it is divisible by 11. Or directly here we can understand that 11 square is 121. Proceeding further, 11 ones are 11. The factors of 5,929 is equals to 7 into 7 into 11 into 11. One pair of 7 and one pair of 11. Square root of 5,929. First we are pairing this. We are taking one digit from this pair. 7 into 11 means what? It is 77. Square root of 5,929 is 77. Or in other words, 77 square is equals to 5,929. I guess you have understood this. Let us see the next sum. 9,216. Let us find the factors of it. This is divisible by 2 because ending by a even digit. 2, 4 is 8, remaining 1. The next value is becoming 12. 2, 6 is 12. Next digit is 1, not divisible. It is smaller than, hence giving 0. And 2, 8 is 16. The next we have. I hope you are understanding this. If you have not understood this concept, or I will just show you this much part of division here. 2, the first digit, 4 is 8, 1 is remaining. Next digit I have brought down, it is becoming 12. 2, 6 is 12, 0. Next digit I brought down, a single digit I have to bring. This digit is smaller than my divisor, therefore I have to multiply by 0. So 2 zeros are 0. Again 1 as it is, and the next digit, that is 16. 2 8s are 16. I have done the same thing here. I guess you have understood it clearly. Next, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 0 as it is, 2 4s are 8. Let us rub this. Okay. Next, again by 2 because it is ending by even digit. 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, 1 remaining. Next value will become 10. 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4. Again by 2 we can divide. 2 5s are 10, 2 7s are 14, 1 remaining, 2 6s are 12. Again by 2 we can divide. 2 2s are 4, 2 8s are 16, 1 remaining. Again 2 8s are 16, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8, 2 4s are 8. Proceeding further, 144. Oh, this has gone crooked. 144. Again by 2 we can. 2 7s are 14, 2 2s are 4. 2 3s are 6, 1 remaining, 2 6s are 12, 2 1s are 2, 1 remaining, 2 8s are 16, 2 9s are 18. Now this is not divisible by 2, so we are taking the next prime number, that is 3. 3 3s are 9 and 3 1s are 3. Totally, how many number of 2 are present in the factor? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So in the prime factors of 9216, 2 is present in a pair of 5, or 10 times 2 is present, one and the same. 4 6 8. Proceeding. 10 and one pair of 3. Let us make pairs 1 2 3 4 5. 5 pairs of 2s means what? In one pair 2 values are present. So 5 pairs of 2 and 1 pair of 3. Let us calculate the square root of 9216. 1, 2 we are taking from each pair. So 5 times 2. Why? Because totally there are 10 times 2 that is present, and pair we have done. So 5 2s are present and 1 pair of 3. This becomes 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 2s are 32. 32 3s are 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. That is 96. Square root of 9216 is 96, or 96 square is equals to 9216. I hope you have understood this. Let us see the next sum. Now I will not do this 529. I will do the 10 sum, 8100 or 8100. 8100. Let us do the factorization here. Prime factorization by 2. 2 4s are 8. Next digit is 1, which is smaller than 2, so 0. Next 2 digits together, it becomes 10. 5s are and 0 as it is. Proceeding further, 2 2s are 4, 0 as it is. 2 2s are 4, 1 carried. 2 5s are 10. Now by 2 it is not possible because the last digit is 5. By 3 let us check. 5 plus 2 7, 7 plus 2 9, means by 3 it is divisible. So 3 we have to take, 2 is smaller, so 20 we shall take. 3 6s are 18. 22, 3 7s are 21, 1 remaining. 3 5s are 15. Let us check again by 3. Before dividing by 3, we shall add this. 7 plus 5 12, 12 plus 6 18, 18 is a multiple of 3. So again by 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 2s are 6, 1 remaining. 3 5s are 15. 5 plus 2 7, 7 plus 2 9, 9 is a multiple of 3. Again 3 7s are 21, 1 remaining, the next value is becoming 15. 3 5s are 7 plus 5 12, means it is divisible by 3. 3 2s are 6, 1 remaining. 3 5s are 15. Now it is by 5. 5 5s are 25 and 5 1s are 5. The prime factors of 8100 is equals to 2 into 2, 3 is present 4 times, means 2 pairs. 3 present 4 times means 2 pairs and 5 in 1 pair. Finding out the square root of 8100, we are making the pairs of the values, the prime factors. 2 is in a single pair, 5 is in a single pair, 3 is in 2 pairs. Therefore, we are taking 1 value from the pairs, 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. This becomes 5 threes are 15, or we can say in this way, 3 twos are 6, 6 fives are 30, and 30 threes are 90. What I did? 3 twos are 6, 6 fives are 30, and 30 threes are 90. So that square root of 8100 is nothing but 90, or I can write 90 square is equals to 8100. In this way, we have calculated square roots. In this way, we have calculated square roots of the numbers by prime factorization method. In the next session, we shall continue with the next question. This session we shall conclude here. So you people take care of yourselves and study properly. Thank you.